we're beautiful.
Welcome back to Angels Light Tarot. Thank you, thank you, thank you for stopping by for your monthly message for June 2020. Can you believe it? We are halfway through the year. Yes, yes, yes. Angels and guides, we are looking for positive energy for Aries for the month of June in the year of our Lord, 2020. Okay, angels, what's going on? What's the energy around Aries? What is the energy around Aries? Tons and tons of messages. I hope you have your tea. Tons and tons and tons of messages for Aries for the month of June, 2020. Angels and guides, positive energy. Yes, yes, yes. There we go. Angels and guides, positive energy for Aries for the month of June in the year of 2020. Yes, yes, yes. There's going to be tons of information here. So hold on tight. Hold on tight. If it gets a little bit, I don't know, if it gets a little bit daunting while you're waiting for me to place the cards down, it's okay. It's okay to just, yeah, just do that. Positive energy. Thank you, thank you, thank you. For Aries for the month of June 2020. One more, please, angels. May we have one more from my mama's day? Yes, yes, yes. And I feel like, yeah, I feel like, yeah, there it is. Moving on to the purple deck. Positive energy. Blow in some love. Blow. Thank you, thank you. That's so funny. The heart chakra came up. Positive energy for Aries for the month of June 2020. Angels and guides, what is going on the month of June? And I feel like that goes there as well. Now, let's move along to the Angels of Light deck. Yes, yes, yes. And then we'll tap it all off with the hummingbirds. And you're like, Dora, how many cards, how many decks are you using? Just a few, just a few, just a few. All right, last deck, the hummingbird deck. Oh, what a year this has been. We need as much information as we possibly, yes, can get. Positive energy, please. Positive energy for Aries, June 2020, angels. What? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you, angels. Positive energy, positive energy. Love, 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 love. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That was amazing. That was amazing. Okay, angels, let's keep these messages coming. Yes, yes, yes. Keep these messages coming for Aries. I feel like, yeah, yeah. Woo, okay, one, two more, three more. Thank you. There's one more. Two more. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. And one more, please. Last card. Last card. Thank you. Thank you. I feel like, yeah, we're just going to leave it just like that, angels. All right. So let's tidy up a bit here and we're going to get right into your messages. I hope you have your coffee and your tea or your tea rather. There's a lot going on here. You're like, Dora, will you hurry up? Yes, yes, yes. Okay, I'm getting there. I'm getting there. Okay, so are we ready? As our feet hit the ground for the month of June, yes, 2020, the major theme for the week is the Ace of Swords, positive movement forward, King of Clubs, King, whoa, of Spades, rest and rejuvenation, Angel of Mother Love, Eight of Clubs, Joker, and the Ace of Diamonds. So, the major theme for the month is there are new beginnings coming. Yes, yes, yes. I know that you know with the Ace of Swords, I know that you know these new beginnings are coming and you know they are going to begin to grow, right? It's not just going to be, boom, a new beginning. No, it's going to be a new beginning that you can nurture, okay? Now, a new beginning, positive movement forward. The King of Clubs, I feel like you will definitely be in charge. You will feel like, you know what? Okay, I got this going on. I'm in control of my life. I'm in control of my family. I'm in control of my home and my finances. With the King of Spades, will it take a lot of work? Yes, yes, absolutely it will. Take time out to rest, to get some rest. Motherly love, I feel like it's time to nurture. It will be time to nurture yourself. With the Eight of Clubs, I know that you're going to want to take time out. You're going to want to nurture, but your brain is not going to let you, because you're going to be like on this train track and you're going to be running and running up here, like not even sleeping. With the Joker card, it's like you don't even know why you're on this road. You don't even know why you're constantly moving. But the Ace of Diamonds is saying there's another new beginning, and that new beginning could possibly be a new financial venture, okay? A new job, a new venture, things of that nature. So yes, there is. It starts off with the Ace of Swords, new beginning, thinking it's going to be long lasting. It's going to be positive. You're going to love it. With the King of Clubs, you may be in a position of leadership, but boy, this leadership is really going to take a lot of work. So get your rest. Nurture yourself with the motherly love. Eight of Clubs, definitely. Don't be stubborn. Do not be stubborn, okay? Because you're going to need that time, yes, for something new that is coming. Maybe a new job, maybe a new financial endeavor, if you will. Now, when we look in the recent past, lots of information here. When we look in the recent past, we had the High Priestess card reversed with the Fulfillment of Wishes, the Jack of Diamonds, the Two of Clubs, the Heart Chakra, with the Angel of Diversity, Two of Spades, and the Three of Diamonds. So in the recent past, you know, you always knew this in the recent past with the High Priestess card reversed. You always knew this, okay? And you knew what it needed to take to fulfill your wishes. You always knew what your heart's desire was, right? And with the Jack of Diamonds, I felt like you felt that, nah, I shouldn't do that. I should be the more responsible one. I see you with the Two of Clubs saying, no, I hear someone even talking to you. No, you have to do the adult thing, right? But your heart, yes, wanted to do the heart chakra. Your heart with the Angel of Diversity wanted to try something creative and different. But I see with the Two of Spades, I feel like you decided to go with a partnership, maybe with a job, maybe with a company, maybe with another person. Yes, but you were always worried. You were always worried about that. Now, that's in the past. Yes, that's in the past. Now, when we look in the middle of the month, we have the Two of Swords reversed with the Spiritual Strength card and the Five of Hearts, the Two of Hearts. The Accelerated Motion, the Angel of Frolic, King of Hearts, Six of Diamonds. So in the middle of the month, I definitely see you making up your mind. Yes, you are making up your mind. This is not an easy decision to make with the Spiritual Strength card. No, it is not. I feel like your feelings around making up your mind, you did it, but your feelings around making up your mind, a very, oh God, up and down. I feel like this has something to do with a love bond. It could be a romantic love bond. It could be with a child, a parent, someone that you have a very deep love connection with. But whatever it is, I see you moving forward aggressively without stopping. There is a little bit of fun. You know, it's not so serious. I hear you saying, I'm not going to take it so seriously. With the King of Hearts, you know that you have the emotional power to do and to do whatever it is you need to do. With the Six of Diamonds, it's almost like you have the ability to smooge. Is that a word? To charm. There you go. To charm, to get what it is that you need. And the Six of Diamonds typically is picked up as financial responsibility. So I see you have the ability to get what you need by, you know, being charming. Okay, you can do this. I know you can. All right, now, when we look at the end of the month, we have the Nine of Wands, the Wisdom card, yes, the Seven of Diamonds, the Ace of Hearts, Emotional Loss, Angel of Beauty, Eight of Diamonds, and the Ten of Hearts. So I definitely am picking up by the end of the month. I feel like you've gone, you've like ran this race, right? You've done a lot. and you're tired. You're tired of looking behind your back. You're just tired, right? But you know everything that has been done with the Wisdom card. You knew it was not for nothing, right? You knew with the Seven of Diamonds, there was something in it. Like it was like, you knew that maybe if you did volunteer work, you knew that it would turn into something good. Maybe if you did overtime or gave more hours to your company, or sometimes in this time with the coronavirus, some people, you know, take a pay cut because they know that eventually they're going to get their job back, but they take the pay cut because they know, gosh, I need to hold on to what I have right now, right? So it's something like that. It's not that, apply it to your life as that fits, okay? And this was all about you. This is all about you. You do feel an emotional loss about that. It's like, I gotta, like, you're feeling like, I can't be attached to money. I can't be attached to money, right? And with the Angel of Beauty, I feel like that is the beauty of it, that you're not attached to the money. And the more you are not attached to the money, the Eight of Diamonds is saying you will receive that which you desire. You will have the finances, the resources that you need. With the Ten of Hearts, I feel like you are going to be surrounded by so much love. I see people lifting you up, almost like, you know what? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes, like you did it. You went the distance for all of us, okay? Now, when we look at your bonus, tons of bonus here, Aries. Let's get right into this. I just need to move the cards, okay? Okay, so the Empress card won the bonus. The Empress card, yes, yes, yes. I'm just gonna go through these. The Empress card is telling me that there is a part of you that is kind of laid back, and you kind of know that everything is going to be okay. With the Death card reversed, you know that there is going to be a new beginning, and you know it's going to come like that, right? And it's going to move. With the Chariot card, it's going to move quickly. And with the King of Swords, I definitely feel like the way it's done, I just hear like, Sade's smooth operator. Yeah, I don't see anybody, like, as it's moving forward, I don't see any aggression or things of that nature. It's just kind of moving forward, and you're ready. You're definitely ready with the Eight of Pentacles. You're ready to put in more work. Yes, oh my gosh, you know what? Yes, you are with the Ten of Wands. You're definitely ready to put in the work. You're not going to, with the Seven of Wands, you're not in a position, or you are not ready, or you don't want to fight, or it's almost like you're not fighting anything in this situation. With the Lovers card, I feel like whatever it is that you're putting that work into, if it is the Lovers card, I definitely feel like it could be romantic. Because this is not a romantic reading, this could be, you know, a love person, a person that you love dearly, a child, a grandparent, a cousin, a nephew. I definitely feel like a brother, a sister. I definitely feel like you're not putting in any work, and maybe any aggression or anything that, like that, because there is someone important in your life. Yes, yes, yes. And you are definitely being patient in this. With the Six of Hearts, you definitely know that things, I feel like, energetically speaking, you know that things will go well, okay? Six of Spades, this is all about these two sixes, Six of Hearts, Six of Spades. This is about responsibility. It's about responsibility to those that you love, responsibility to your health and to your work. The Three of Spades, I definitely feel that you are kind of feeling like you're in between. You're being pulled from different directions. I feel like you might be pulled from one part your family, one part your work, right? And that might be a good thing. Movement, choices, and decisions. You're going to have to make a decision, I feel, between the two. Financial material changes are coming. Yes, yes, yes. Spiritual exploration. Do the inner work. Things that have challenged you in the past, let it go. Definitely let it go, because you have the power to overcome anything. With the Eight of Spades, you have the power. Gosh, this ends on two eights. These eights are all about power. You have the power in emotions, and you have the power in work, okay? So now let's match that up with the power. So whatever it is you're overcoming, with the Six of Hearts, you have the ability to overcome it with the Eight of Hearts. With the Six of Spades, you have the ability to overcome it with the Eight of Spades. So maybe you're not making a decision. Maybe you're doing it all. Maybe you're being responsible in all of these departments in your life. Almost like, you know what? it's a lot is being put on your plate at one time. There's a lot of changes that are happening. There's newness that's coming. But I see that you have this, but make sure you take time out, Aries, to rest and rejuvenate yourself, because there's going to be a lot on your plate at one time. I know that you can handle this. I know that you can. And you know that you're going to make this decision. You know, I feel like you're making this decision for a loved one, for yourself, maybe for your family, maybe for your partner. But take time out and love on you. Take that time to rest, okay? So I send you joy, namaste, and much, much love sent your way.